Neutral forehead, but low blow back of the head and spine. I want to clear for a fight.
Okami could not contemplate a second loss here in one championship, going 0-2. And for Nakashima, well, he wants to go 12-0 and send a very strong message to the world's champion, Sebastian Canestar.
Good head movement right now utilized by Nakashima as Okami's trying to put out that jab. You see they're both coming out of that southpaw stance. So it's really going to come down to that center line of that footwork. As Okami shoots in for a single leg, backs Nakashima up into the corner. Let's see what kind of defense that Nakashima can come up with here. As
both men are BJJ purple belts. Nakashima on an 11-fight win streak. Okami, judo, first-degree black belt.
Okami's bringing a different type of grappling to Nakashima. You know, that judo style background that, you know, Okami's got, it's hard to deal with, especially in those clinch positions. But Nakashima's a very good wrestler.
Nakashima is always very patient, very methodical. You can almost see his brain just ticking over every second, James Nakashima.
Tried to hit that switch and spin around to the back, but Okami was going to let it go. Stayed nice and tight to the body. You can see how Nakashima's trying to peel the hands off.
He can spin
and go chest to chest, but he's having a hard time because Okami keeps adjusting the grips. So once, there he goes, now he spins. Okami immediately shoots in for a double leg, and now we can start to see if Nakashima can pull the head up of Okami. Good takedown there by Okami, the veteran, utilizing that skill. You can just see that world-class experience of Okami. He's not worried about the neck, not worried about defending the neck. He immediately attacks the legs, so Nakashima can't adjust his positions.
Nakashima, national wrestling champion in 2009, legacy Fighting Alliance welterweight champion, won the title against Derek Kranz back in September 2017, defended it against Carl Stewart. Back-to-back wins in one championship over Raymond Magomedliev and also over Rusev.
That's another one. Look at that crank. He's going out.
Oh, is Okami going to go to sleep?
Oh, yeah, he's going belly down. Look at that transition.
Almost.
Going to the mount. Okami does a good job of getting back into half guard.
Oh, this would be tragic for Okami.
Oh, looks like he might survive this. Nakashima might not have the grip position.
Look at the
either
veins in the head there of Okami.
How relaxed. He looks okay, though. He looks like he's relaxed.
Not look okay. He looks like those veins are going to burst through the skin, Dragon.
Look at his face. He's not even flinching. He's okay. I think
his blood vessels say otherwise.
Look at him. He's relaxed. He's calm. That's Okami, man. He's all right. Cranking on the head. Look at Nakashima.
If that's him relaxed, I'd hate to see what he looks like angry.
Hey, he's fine. He's thinking about, you can see his hands are in weird positions, like he's trying to tap, but he's not.
Was it close there, though, for Nakashima?
It looked close. You said they looked close. I thought it looked mediocre. Good job by Okami to stay completely relaxed and composed as he adjusts, and now Nakashima's on top.
Nakashima just missed with that right elbow. Bad start for Yushin Okami there.
This is what Nakashima wanted. He wanted to get on top of Okami, have him feel that weight. Nakashima talked a lot about how, you know, he wanted to feel what Okami was like. Okami, you know, challenged some of the very best in the world. And this is like a very good measuring stick for Nakashima, just to see how he compares on that world stage. You know, Sapo, his last victory was an incredible performance. He was able to stop Sapo in the second round via injury. And he just looked really good. And now this is a huge step up in competition for him. This is really going to let him know where he's at in the competitive ladder as he tries to work his way up, you know, to possibly get in a title shot.
40 seconds remains. Nakashima.
Okami's very crafty on that guard. Created a little bit of space. Once he found his opening, he immediately sat up and went into that single leg. Now Nakashima's going to have to sprawl heavy to avoid that single leg, and he does. Now we can try to pull him back up. Now they're in that 50-50 pummel position as Nakashima's trying to frame off the hips there, create a little bit of space so he can deliver knees.
You actually need to go back to April 2018 to find the last win for Okami against Diego Lima. The record of Nakashima, dating way back to January 2015. They're all wins, of course. Former RFA, then on hollow fight.
His feet. You put Nakashima on the ground, he's much like a fish in water. Keep him on the feet. Utilize that jab. There it is. Watch Nakashima start to go to work on that the leg. Look how wide the stance Okami has.
Don't forget, though, this is Nakashima, who's been training in Italy with the great one, Giorgio Petrosian. Big jab there from Okami. And again, big unit, Yushin Okami.
Now he's starting to go to work with that jab. Look how much kind of reach he's got.
Chance for the knees here.
See Okami inside that clinch. They've got kind of that uppercut. One hand on there. Dirty boxing coming from Nakashima right now.
Three-punch combination gets him out of that predicament. Southpaw stance on both these men. Nakashima thrusts out the jab, circles off to his right. There's a jab from Okami. Shoots down low, good sprawl there from Nakashima. Back to their feet.
Good defense by Nakashima. I like the work that Okami was doing with that jab. He's can just see the speed difference between the two. Even at 38 years old, Okami's just got a little bit more pepper, a little bit more snap to his punches than Nakashima does, regardless of the Petrosian training or not.
Georgia Petrosian will be in action in it. Petrosian playbook. Beautiful left hand from Nakashima. Looking for the finish now. And Okami got dropped.
James Nakashima coming over the top with a huge left hand. Drops Okami. And now Nakashima's in a very good position to do a lot of damage right now.
I was going to say, Giorgio Petrosian in action in Bangkok, August 16, against Smoke and Joe Nadawat in the kickboxing Grand Prix semi-final. Turnaround for Petrosian. Big hands for Nakashima tonight.
Petrosian training's coming in a lot more handy than I anticipated. He was able to come over the top of that jab. Maybe he was using the jab of, you know, Okami. He was just taking it just so he could time that big left hand. Good, I like the way he pulls away that hand, flattens out Okami, forces him to go to his back. This is where Nakashima does his best work when he's on top.
Welterweight champion is Sebastian Katastam. No doubt the Swede keeping a close eye on both these two, particularly James Nakashima, who comes in 11-0.
Nice little sneaky elbow there from Nakashima as he's sitting in the half guard now. This is Nakashima's position. He just loves that half guard. So he just feels better control with the ground and pound.
Okami, one of six Japanese athletes on tonight's card. Already a win for Ayaka Miura earlier on against Samara Santos of Brazil. So Team Japan, 1-0 coming in. Following this one, we'll see Daichi Takanaka against Leandro Issa. Of course, in our main event, Koyomi Matsushima goes up against Martin Ewan and challenges for the featherweight world title. Big night for Team Japan in Manila. Return to Tokyo on October 13. Another stellar card for ONE Championship's 100th event.
Okami tried to get that underhook, tried to work his way back up to his feet when he sat up, but Nakashima immediately sensed it, stuck his head under the arm, put Okami back down on his butt. Let's see if Okami can get back up to his feet. He does.
Stay inside.
Nakashima's still applying that pressure. He's got the back. Okami circles over to the corner now. Okami is going to go back to that grip fighting. He's going to try to separate the hands and spin and go chest to chest with Nakashima. Ooh, Nakashima attacks that leg, stomps on the back of the knee.
40 seconds remaining, second of three of what has been a very good contest for America's James Nakashima.
Good back control right now from James Nakashima. Okami's trying to separate the hands. That's the game. He's going to try to separate those hands, create a little bit of space, turn, go chest to chest so he can go back to work inside that pummel.
Nakashima, who wrestled at NCAA Division 1 University of Nebraska along with Jordan Burroughs.
And those Cornhuskers are serious grapplers.
Stay inside.
Nice sneaky punches here from Nakashima as he's going around the corner here. Stop. outside the ring.
On Instagram for all the latest ONE Championship news, interviews, highlights, videos, live streams, and a whole lot more. Follow us now on all your social media on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Great contest so far for undefeated James Nakashima with his mum in the audience tonight here at the Mall of Asia Arena.
Mama's given him some serious confidence and power going into this one. But I don't think Nakashima needed very much of it. He's doing good work. He's done good work his entire career. He's sticking to what works. But we're also seeing new skills being developed in Nakashima, like that jab, the straight left hand that you commented on, that dropped Okami.
Where did it come from?
I think it came from Italy.
Nice little cork, he needed the inside left thigh there from Nakashima. Nakashima doing everything right, and Okami's got to put the foot down. He's got to press hard on the gas now. What does he need specifically to do to try and swing this one in his favor, Dragon?
He's got to put that jab out there. He's trying to take down Nakashima, and Nakashima's able to defend it. That's two in this round that Nakashima's been able to develop. Stop. I like to see that jab coming from Okami. Start working the kicks. Okami's got good boxing, and we're not seeing much of it right now. So throw out that jab. Touch up that eye. Look at the damage underneath the eye of Nakashima. Use that as target practice and start piecing him up. There he goes. Let him go.
You've got to wonder if Nakashima does get the win here tonight, how close he might be to possibly a world title tilt against Sebastian Katastama
against Nakashima. Ooh, that's going to be a good one. But he's got to get past Thunder right now.
You look at the many great names on the record of James Nakashima over the years, but I'll tell you what, Mitch, none of them compare to the whole different breed of animal that is Sebastian Katastama, our champion.
Katastama's hungry. I know he's listening right now. He's improving every single day. His ground game is getting better and better to go with that world-class striking that he's got.
Forcing Okami back into the corner here. Chance for the knees again from Nakashima.
Okami's got to try to pummel in right now. Nakashima's got double underhooks, so Okami's got to try to get one of his arms on the inside of the arm. But they have a lot of judo throws from this position. He can switch his hips and move around, or just turn the corner.
Nice little elbow for the break there from Nakashima. Shoots in for a double to Okami, gets a takedown.
That was a good takedown there from Okami. Getting deep to the hips.
Stay inside, inside. Inside.
2 minutes, 10 remaining. Third and final round. Olivia Costa, referee right on top of the action. Filipino fans can, of course, watch all the action on ABS-CBN Sports in action tonight. Philippines, in all their glory, in the Mall of Asia Arena.
See, Okami's trying to drag him around. Nakashima's trying to fight those hands, peel those hands apart. He might be able to spin without it.
Ropes.
Good balance shown there by Nakashima as he pops back up, ends up in top. Nice scramble from Nakashima. Gets a little bit of frame off that, cross faces in, pushes Okami back down.
Mitch, I know that you hadn't seen much of Nakashima before he signed with ONE Championship, and now seeing him again tonight, how much does he impress you?
Man, he impresses me a lot. I'm used to the wrestling. I went back when he first debuted here in ONE Championship, and I saw a lot of his footage, and I saw that top pressure, that wrestling that he had. But now, especially with the hands, I like the boxing that I'm seeing from Nakashima, the timing that he had, the way that he baited him with that, touching him with those jabs, and then he came over the top with that beautiful left hand.
Nothing seems to fluster Nakashima. He's got this stoic approach. Every time he's in the ring or in the circle, nothing flusters him.
He's very composed. It's a lot of that mental training that he's been doing. He says he's going out there and he's seeking time with, you know, psychologists and mental coaches, so where he knows that 90% of a match is mental. 90% of training is physical, but when you get in here, you have to be able to throw that switch, and that's what he's working on. He wants to keep that undefeated streak intact and challenge for the title.
Within training jabs. Okami looking for the one big punch, perhaps off the left hand here out of southpaw. There it goes to the jaw, swings it again. Nakashima drifts back to center ring.
You can also see the way that Nakashima's movement. He said he was going to have a problem with southpaw versus southpaw. And I know he gets to work with a lot of good guys out there, including Benson Henderson, who's a good southpaw. and we're starting to see Nakashima circle to the left.
Jeez.